Assalamualaikum guys, I am Ghazan Frawley, your chemistry tutor, and today we are going to discuss about the Wood-Swittage reaction. So what is Wood-Swittage reaction? Wood-Swittage reaction is a coupling reaction. It is a coupling reaction in organometallic chemistry. Organometallic chemistry. Wood's reaction is a coupling reaction in the organometallic chemistry in which alkyl halides and aryl halides react with sodium in the presence of dry ether, to give substituted aromatic compound. So what is Wood-Swittage reaction? Wood-Swittage reaction is a coupling reaction in which alkyl halides and aryl halides react with sodium in the presence of dry ether to give substituted aromatic compounds. So why we use dry ether? Why we use dry ether in the Wood-Swittage reaction? Dry ether is a nonpolar, aprotic solvent, nonpolar aprotic solvent. So it does not react with the sodium. And as we know that sodium is a highly reactive metal, so our reaction medium should be free from any moisture content or oxygen content. If there is any oxygen content or moisture content present in the reaction medium, then sodium reacts rapidly with the moisture content or with the oxygen content and gives sodium oxide, and if it reacts with the moisture content, then there is formation of sodium hydroxide and hydrogen gas evolves. So if there is any moisture content or oxygen content present in the reaction medium, then the sodium reacts with the moisture content and oxygen and disturbs the reaction. We will not get the substituted aromatic compounds. That's why we use dry ether, because it is a nonpolar aprotic solvent and does not react with the sodium. If alkyl fluorides or aryl fluorides are used as a reactant, use tetrahydrofuran as a solvent. This is the tetrahydrofuran. In case of alkyl fluorides and aryl fluorides, we use tetrahydrofuran as a solvent because it is a polar aprotic solvent. If we have any alkyl halide, it reacts with any aryl halide, the reaction takes place in the presence of sodium and dry ether. Then there is a formation of a substituted aromatic compound. And there is also a formation of a sodium halide. So what is the mechanism of this reaction? As sodium is a highly reactive metal, so it gives, and secondly it is highly electropositive element, so it gives its electron very easily. And we have alkyl halides, and X is a electron withdrawing group. So there is a single electron transfer takes place. This electron is transferred to the alkyl group and single electron transfer takes place. These electrons are attracted by the X, and there is a formation of alkyl free radical and the halidine. And we have the second sodium give its electron. aryl halide. So single electron transfer takes place like this. Single electron transfer takes place. It attacks on this electropositive side. The halide ion eliminated. The X eliminated in the form of halide ion, and there is a formation of aryl free radical. This aryl free radical and this alkyl free radicals are highly reactive. They are highly reactive, so they react rapidly. They react rapidly to give substituted aromatic compounds. So this is the free radical mechanism of the Wood-Swittig reaction, in which firstly there is a single electron transfer takes place. There is a formation of alkyl free radical that is highly reactive and highly unstable. And secondly, there is also formation of the aryl free radical. This alkyl free radical and this aryl free radical reacts rapidly to give the substituted aromatic compounds. There is another example of, for example, we have ethyl bromide. Ethyl bromide reacts with aryl halide in the presence of sodium and dry ether. So there is a formation of ethyl benzene. There is a formation of ethyl benzene that is a substituted aromatic compound, and secondly, there is also formation of sodium bromide. This sodium and these two bromides. So this is all about the Wood-Swittig reaction.